guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Yeah guys, by the title of this video, you guys already know what this video is all about. So in this video, I'm going to be sharing with you guys on how you can actually add your mulatto soap into your black soap. I dropped a video that I was talking about ingredients that you can incorporate into your black soap to activate your black soap into a whitening soap. I know majority of you were asking me questions like, can I add a mulatto soap into the black soap to equally activate it? And I replied you guys, some of you guys, yes. So, but in me, I have it in mind to drop a video that will explain to you more better. Okay, so this is the video I'm going to be explaining to you guys on how you can actually incorporate your bath soap into your black soap. Yes, now the reason of that is to help to activate the black soap. Normally, black soap doesn't whiten the skin. Please take note, it doesn't whiten the skin. It all depends on the ingredient that you add into it that will boost the effect, that will make it be a whitening soap or a brightening soap or a lightening soap. Okay, so in this video is where I'm going to be putting you guys through on that. So before then, you guys should pardon my grater, because this grater is fine. Yes, I can lay my hands on the new ones that I bought. I've searched for it inside my storehouse, but I can't lay my hands. So this is what I can lay my hands. So let's just use it. Okay, yeah, so this is one of the grater ones I used the last time to make our mulatto soap, the ones that we are selling, me and my staff. So it's really faulty, but I will have to manage this. Yeah, so the black soap that I'm going to be using in this recipe is this cottage fresh Ghanaia pure herbal soap. It's super toner. This is a very black soap paste, a very good black soap paste, Ghanaia black soap paste. Yeah, so if you can lay your hands on this, which I know it's popular in the market, you can get this. So we're going to be using this in place of the African black soap. It's still an African black soap, but the difference is that this is in a paste form, yeah, compared to the other one that is in a solid form. So whichever one you choose to use, this is the one we're going to be using. Now, in as much that I'm going to be activating this into a whitening black soap, I'm equally going to be adding important ingredient that will help to repair the skin. Now, this black soap is not only going to whiten your skin, it's also going to be repairing your skin at the same time. So please take note. Okay, yeah, so like if you have eczema, ringworms, all of that on your skin, is going to help and help to lighten your skin, which is our number one ingredient. Now, the number two ingredient that we're going to be using is our Dudu Osun black soap that's in a bath form. So yeah, if you can lay your hands on this as well, it's very good. Like I said before, this soap, we're going to be using it on our face, on our body as well. So this is one of the ingredients that we need in this recipe. Now, the next ingredient that we need in this recipe is our carotene. Yes, our carotene is the one that is going to be doing the whitening in this recipe. This is one of the ingredients that I'm going to be using in this recipe, and you all know what carotene does to the skin. Yeah, so the next ingredient I'm going to be incorporating into this black soap is our carotene, and the next ingredient is the carotene, which is this. So this is another ingredient that we're going to be incorporating inside this recipe. Now, these two are the two ingredients that is going to be doing the work, the main work. Okay, yes, these are the two ingredients that is going to be doing the main work in this recipe. Yes, so please take notes. So I'm also going to be introducing other ingredients into it as time goes on. So, but let's just start with this ones that I showed to you guys. Now, this Dudu Osun black soap that we're going to be using, I'm not going to be using all of it, I'm just going to be using half of it. Yes, so it's It's an illustration video, so I'm not going to be using everything because I still need the soap. Yeah, so I'm going to be making just a little batch of it. So first of all, I'm going to be grading it into smaller amounts that I can be able to use. But if you want to make all of it, no problem. So I'm just needing half of it, so I'm just going to grade half of the soap. So, and guys, I'm going to be doing it off camera so that it will not be stressful for me. So when I'm done, I'm going to bring you guys back. But before then, let me first of all divide it into half pieces so that you guys will see it, that I actually use the half, because most of you are dirty Thomas. So sorry to say, but that's just the truth. So I'm going to be needing half, like I said. The half is what I'm grading, which is this. Then I'm going to be keeping this one. So the next one is this one. I'm also going to be needing half. So I'm going to be doing the cutting so that you guys will see, because I'm going to be doing it off camera because I don't want this video to be long. I'm just trying for me to be to minimize the length of this video. So I'm needing just half of it. As you can see, it's half, just half. Then yeah, the next one is this Caro Wise bar soap. Equally going to be needing half. So this will help to lighten, the case may be whiten your skin. Yeah, so only need half. Okay, so you can go ahead and use all of this ones. That's the whiten, these ones, you can use just one of it, no problem. But I'm just using half. Okay, let's use all of it. Let's use all of it. No, let's use more than half. Let's use more than half in this whitening. Let's use more than half. Look at the way I pieces it. So this one, I'm going to keep it. So I don't want it to be much inside so that the color will still be as dark as possible, like a black soap. Okay, so these are what I'm going to be incorporating into it. So I'm going to be shading it off camera so that this video will not be long. So guys, I'm back. Meanwhile, please, if you're hearing noise, please pardon. That's because the generator is on, so I need to finish this video because there is no NEPA, there is no electricity. I have to put on the generator so that I'll be able to film this video. Okay, so yeah, I'm done grading my brass soaps, which is the Caro White brass soap and the Caro Tune bath soap, and also the Dudu Osun bath soap. No, you know, we use half of it, then I graded the other half. Why we use more than half of this in this recipe, meaning this ones. Yeah, so I had to do it off camera because it took me time to grade all of this, so it's not that easy because these soaps are very, very hard to grade. So this is it. And this is the Dudu Osun. That's what I created first before this ones. As you can see how beautiful the soap look. So yeah, so after you grade the soap, then you measure out this one. Now, for majority of you that would like to add your whitening powders into this soap, you can go ahead. But to me, I don't feel there is need for it because the soaps that I add into it are already going to do the work that I want the soap to do for me. So I don't think it's necessary because it's just waste of powders. You can go ahead and add your serums And I know most of you will say, but I said that you should not add your serums and powders when you're making the soap. Now, I did not say you should not add it when you're making the black soap. So this one is obviously we are making a black soap. This is not mulatto soap. Okay. So, but to me, there is no need for all of those ingredients, because that's why I add more than half of this soap into it to boost the effect of this black soap. But if you feel like you want to add your serums, you want to add every other thing, no problem. You can go ahead and add. Okay. So, but this is how this recipe is. So I'm going to be adding the amount that I want in this recipe. So you can add as much as you want, but this is the amount that I want in this recipe. I still want it to have this not really dark color, like black. No, I still want it to have a little of this color, like mulatto color somehow. I guess I'm in love with mulatto sauce. So we've added like 4 spoons of the cottage. The cottage, yeah. So that's how many now? I guess that's 5. So let's add more. Okay. 5, 6. Let's add more. 1. So yeah, sorry guys, that's the last one we add. So that's it. So you can decide to use all of it. Everybody have their own way of making their soaps. So this is how it look like. So after you've done that, then you have to mix it together. But now I'm not going to mix it without adding my my shower gel in it. So I'm going to be adding my shower gel. But I made mention that when you're making your soap, do not add water. Water can reduce the effect of the soap. If assuming I have a lot of this whitening glycerin, that's what I'll use to activate it, like pour it inside so that it will soften the soap. Yeah, so but since I don't have enough of it, I'm going to be using my shower gel in it. Sorry, help me with the shower gel. I'm going to be using my shower gel in it so that I can be able to mix it properly. So I'm going to be needing half of my shower gel. So this is my shower gel I'm going to be using. So this is a whitening shower gel. So you can use any shower gel of your choice. So I'm going to be using just a little of it because I still want it to be creamy. So you can use a shower gel of your choice, please. A shower gel of your choice. Not must that you use the one that I use. A shower gel of your choice will do. So then you mix it all together. Okay, this is how you make your whitening black soap. You don't add water into it, please. I keep saying that. Don't add your water into it. Don't add your water into it. So you can leave it to sit for some time before you mix them together. No problem, you can do that. Or you can decide to hand mix it, like use your hand mixer to mix it. Or you can decide to leave them to sit for 24 hours to ferment properly before you blend. So I guess we're going to be leaving it to sit for 24 hours. So that we can be able to blend it properly. Yeah. Let's leave it to sit for 24 hours. Then after much, we're going to come back to see the outcome. Okay, so I'm going to be leaving it to sit for 24 hours. Meanwhile, I'm going to be using my foil paper to cover it so that it can sit for 24 hours. Then after which, then we mix it properly together. Okay,
This has been sitting for like, let me say, if I'm not mistaken, for like 6 to 5 days. Yes, I purposely left it to sit for that long, and also the fact that my camera was giving me issues, so I needed to leave it to sit for that long. As you can see how it is, okay, you see it's very, very soft, very, very soft to blend now. As you can see, very soft. So now I'm going to be blending it so that we have to see the consistency together. So I'm using my hand. To mix it all together. So I'm done blending the soap. As you can see how it turns out very smooth. You see, nobody will even notice that I add other bar soap into it. Yeah, as you can see how smooth it turns out. You see, so you have to blend it very well so that every ingredient will mix properly. As you can see, everything is well mixed. I know, as you can see through the my camera, you can see clearly that everything is mixed. There is no sign of me adding the bar soaps into it. So for those of you that will be asking, this is the bar soaps. If you watch from the beginning, you know the soaps that I incorporate into this recipe. So this is one of the soap, and also I add the Carol White. That's the Carol White, the bar soap, into it as well. I also include this cottage fresh pure herbal soap. Yeah, so this is the paste black soap anyway, Sha. For those of you that will be asking, this is how it look like inside. So if you cannot lay your hand on this, you can use the normal black soap, but I prefer to use this because I love this the fragrance, and also I love the fact that it also helps to tune up the skin. So age people can use it, everybody can use it. It helps to fight any form of bacterias from the skin, and it also helps to clean the skin very well. Okay, that is, it helps to exfoliate the skin. So that's why I go for this, and the fact that it contains lemon, so I love the smell of lemon. So that's why I use this. So also you can use this, like you can add this. So this is another anti-irritant bar soap that you can incorporate into your bar, into your black soap. Yes, for those of you that don't know. So if you're prone to bacterias, like you have the skin infection, like eczema, all of that, you can incorporate this alongside when you're adding other whitening bar soap into it. Just take one of it or a little of it, depend the batch size you're making. Okay, so you can incorporate this. This will help to prevent every skin irritation and infection like eczema and the rest of it. Okay, so I also include the Dudu Osun soap as well. Yeah, so